Hi, Pile 3.
So apparently it wasn't recording the entire first half of your reading. So anyway, we're going to discuss what I was discussing before. This person that is gossiping about you or people could be people that have fooled themselves into seeing themselves in a different way. They may be very confused about what to believe, what not to believe. They don't rely on their intuition very much. They have been listening to a lot of the gossip or slander going on around you, and they really messed things up. I feel like they messed things up a lot. And a lot of that is because they've been in a prison of their own making in their mind over authoritarian people in their past who pushed them to be one way, and you can't go down any other path. You need to be this way, period. And I feel like for a long time now, they've been viewing themselves as this rebel who does things differently than other people do things. And they have really been seeing themselves as somebody who stands out from the crowd, does their own thing, does what they want to do, listens to their intuition, but they really haven't been. And I feel like they're seeing themselves a lot more clearly at this point. But when you guys first met, they were really disregarding a lot of that, and they were just listening to the gossip going around. They were very confused about what to believe, what to think about you. And I also feel like they may have even been told that you were somebody who was very authoritarian, very harsh, very overly critical. And I feel like they are actually very harsh and overly critical and authoritarian in a lot of ways themselves, because they've been trapped in this mental prison. And I feel like this person is starting to see now that they really haven't been doing things in as rebellious of a way as they thought they had been in the past, because they're watching you. And you are somebody who stands out very strongly from the crowd. You are somebody who picks your path and goes down it, regardless of what anybody else thinks, because you can see things very clearly. You trust in your intuition. You trust in your gifts. You trust in your power. And I feel like this person has a lot of gifts as well, and they have shunned them or disregarded them or not really believed in them fully, thought they were crazy, things like that, because other people have planted this in their head and they're stuck in it. I feel like this person could be somebody who travels a lot, somebody who maybe even runs away from things they know are good for them because they are busy trying to please the crowd instead of doing things on their own. And I feel like they see you as somebody who doesn't do that, somebody who does what you want to do regardless of what anybody else thinks. They also are seeing you as somebody very open, very charismatic. You could be an acquaintance of theirs, or they could just be telling people that you're an acquaintance of theirs, because they may already be in a very solid, significant relationship. Like, they may have a husband or a wife, and you guys may have been intimate at one point, and they didn't tell you they had a husband or wife, and they told everyone else that you were just a friend or an acquaintance. This could be somebody who sees you as having a lot of acquaintances because you're a very open, charismatic person. They could be even somebody who has that themselves. This could also be somebody who wants to make you their wife or husband, and that could be what's going on there. So this person may even be telling people that you are their wife or husband, even if you aren't. This person is telling people that you're very playful, very energetic, very youthful, very goal-oriented, very passionate, motivated, driven, ambitious, somebody who is a leader. And you lead by example. You don't just lead by saying something, you lead by doing, and you show others how it's done. And this person felt like that's what they were doing, and I feel like they weren't actually doing that because they were stuck in their head about what everyone else around them thought, especially the people that were very strong-willed or very stubborn around them that were pushing them to do things the way they thought they should be doing. This could be somebody who may be in a very high position work-wise. They could be the leader of their own company or business, and they could be feeling very stuck, very drained, very tired because they work so much. They could even be telling other people that you overwork a lot and that you are busy trying to learn as much as you can, and sometimes it drains you very much as well. So let's see what else we got here. We have your hair color stands out so much, your style too for some. You are very different and you accept that and you gain strength from it. So this person is stuck. They are somebody, I feel like this person is somebody that can be stuck in masculine roles and feminine roles. They could be somebody that also takes and projects everything that they are onto the opposite sex. Like if they're a man and they're very, very sexualized, they project that onto women around them and think that they're very sexualized, even if they aren't, and they hate them for it. Or if they're a woman, they may take some of the more masculine qualities about themselves, or some of the more, like, they're very vulnerable, very sensitive, very, like, they cry a lot, things like that. And they take that and project that on men around them and hate them for being weak and needy, or they take and project whatever it is about themselves onto the opposite sex and hate them for it. Yeah. So your hair stands out. You are somebody very different from other people. You stand out from the crowd. You are a leader. You are somebody who's a trendsetter as well. A blessing is coming into you soon. Open your heart and your eyes. Believing is seeing. Know that you are protected and your life purpose. I'm sorry about the traffic, guys. It is very beautiful here. Very beautiful, except for the fact that there is a highway right there. And for some reason, the moment I decided to do a video, there's 5 million people going down it. Anyway, believing is seeing. Know that you are protected and your life purpose is very supported. So, you got a lot of blessings. You got a lot of blessings coming your way. Whatever you're working on is very important. It's very supported by the world around you, and it's going to be very supported by your angels, by your spirit guides, things like that. This person may even reach out to give you a gift of support of some kind. They may even be proposing as well. There could be somebody here receiving a proposal. Your starlight shines so bright. You are me and want to, or you are me. So this person really sees you mirrored in them, or them mirrored in you. Like I was saying before, I feel like this person thought they were very, very, very rebel until they seen you. And then they were like, shit, how did I fall out of that? And now they're like climbing back up into that and standing in their own power again, where they were giving a lot of their power away before. I feel like you helped this person see who they truly are and step into it more without feeling so guilty about it or so judgmental about themselves being themselves. Sadie, mama. Okay. Sorry, want to make sure my dog was over here because there's people pulling in. Your starlight shines so bright. You are meant to be seen and heard. You bring hope and peace to others. So you are somebody who shines very bright. You are somebody who is very hopeful, somebody who has a lot of faith, somebody who really is very inspiring to other people. And you bring other people a lot of hope, faith, and trust. Now this guy is parking next to me and leaving his truck running. Really? I really hope you guys can hear me because I only got so long on this video. They don't know what they want. They are always changing. They walk away too easily. Or you just have boundaries and you learn and grow. Stuck people that are stagnant and accept any behavior can't understand this. So like I was saying before, this person is stuck. They're stuck in a past way of thinking. They're stuck on a lot of the things that people who were very bully-like in their life, people who were very authoritarian in their approach, they're stuck on those things, and they don't understand why you walk away when people are treating you like crap. But when people are treating you like crap and trying to pull this power card on you, you're not going to stick around for that. And so they're learning a lot by you walking away from them as well. It's good for their health. You are a liar who is playing the victim. You were never hurt and caused pain in all of your life. You are domineering and controlling. Some may even say that you are physically, emotionally, or mentally abusive. You hurt me, so I am lashing out at you. You broke free of my control, and I don't want others to see the real me, so I blame you and I distort the truth to fit a reality where I come out looking good. I can't have others see the real me. Remember, truth always comes out. So this person, like I was saying, this person isn't seeing things clearly. They were very confused about what's going on. I feel like this person is playing the victim, and they're playing it so much that they believe it themselves, and they believe that you're the one who has hurt them. When in all actuality, they were the ones who hurt you. They probably pulled some kind of power card on you, like, I have the money, so I make the rules, even though you're working like a slave for them. It could have even been a boss. And yeah, this person is just trying to make people believe that you are somehow the one that was in the wrong, like you cheated on them, or you did this, or you did this, and they were the ones who did those things to you. They were controlling, they were manipulative, they were trying to pull the power card, but they want to blame it on you so that other people aren't looking at them. They wanted you to have to rely on them and come to them only. So this person is doing this because they wanted you to have to rely on them and them only. They tried to isolate you from other people so you didn't have anybody around you. They tried to make you feel like you couldn't survive without them. And when you showed them that, hey, I don't need you, I can take care of my damn self. I didn't have you 5 minutes ago, and guess what? I don't need you 5 minutes from now either. That's when they were like, oh shit, I better start making up lies and rumors about them. You are generous and loving, and they couldn't handle it. They had a lot going on and they couldn't see clearly. Once again, they couldn't see clearly. This person was stuck in this world of their own creation, this world of all the people of the past who have hurt them, their creation, and this person really couldn't see clearly. They couldn't see that the love and care was really genuine. They couldn't really see that you walking away was self-love. They thought that you were trying to hurt them, that you were trying to give them all this beauty that you gave them and then take it away. But what they didn't realize is they were crossing your boundaries and you were setting them straight. Ugh, this traffic is freaking annoying. You were setting the boundaries, or your boundaries, and setting them straight, and they couldn't handle you setting your boundaries, so you walked away. They wanted to stop your growth because they thought that you would leave them. So this person wanted to stop your growth because they thought that you would leave them if they allowed you to continue growing. And guess what? You did leave them because they didn't want to grow with you. They could have chose to grow with you. There's actually a song about that, about growing together. People can grow together, but it takes two people to want to grow together, and this person wasn't wanting to grow. Don't let their shade bring out your shadows. Don't allow others to dim your shine. Step up your game and refuse to give this person any more of your time and energy. It's time to tell this person to fuck off, and it's time to not to do it in a harsh way. Just be like, hey, I'm sorry, we discussed what I want, and if you don't want that, then we don't need to be spending this time together anymore. And don't allow their negativity to bring out yours. So, that's what I have for this pile. I really hope you guys enjoyed this reading. I would love to hear what you have to say about it in the comments below, whether or not it resonated, what you might be going through, things like that. And if you guys enjoyed this video, please give it a like, share, and subscribe. It really does help my channel. And I hope you guys have a beautiful night or day, whatever it is, wherever you are when you're watching. Bye-bye, guys. Pile 3. So for you guys, this is the picture we got. I feel like this is somebody that, there may have been a lot of mirroring energy going here, but it was a distorted mirror. This person was very much so locked in their shadow energy. This person may have been spying on you as well. This person really can't see themselves clearly. This person may think that they are a very good person. They may think that they, or they may even think that they're a very evil person. But this person, either way, they couldn't see themselves clearly. And in this distorted perception of their reality and view of themselves, they have distorted the view of you as well. This person, I feel like they may have put you on a pedestal of some sort. They have a lot of unconditional love for you. They really speak some good things about you from the heart as well. But I feel like there's some very bad things that this person has been saying about you too. And a lot of those bad things they've been saying about you, it's because they can't see their own image clearly, and therefore they can't see your image clearly. They are seeing in a very distorted lens. They're looking through a very distorted lens when it comes to themselves and people around them. So we have calculating person. This person's very calculated. Family friend. Child. This could be a family friend. Could be your child. Lonely person. Could be the child of a family friend. This person may say that you're a child. This person may say that you're a lonely person. I'm a lonely chick. Ooh. Ah. That song's what popped in my head. I was doing better on my own. This person's a very calculating person. This person may have actually went behind your back and made friends with your family. They could have even already been a family friend. Maybe you didn't even know that when you met this person. This person may have met you as a child as well, and then you re-met them as an adult. This person, though, I feel like this person is very childish a lot of times as well. This person may be somebody who's very lonely. They may be very introverted, but they may also be somebody who's very lonely. And I feel like even if you are introverted, you have learned a lot about being on your own and standing strong on your own. At the same time, you could be somebody who falls into loneliness at times. You may have even let this person get very close to you because of loneliness. So let's see what else we got. We have the hawk and we have the elephant. This person may be a very powerful person, and this person views you as somebody who's very powerful. They view you as somebody who receives a lot of messages from the other side, who has a higher perspective, who sees things very clearly. You're somebody who's very detailed, very calculating. This person sees you as somebody who's very calculating. I feel like you guys mirror each other a lot. Whoever this person is, you guys mirror each other a lot. And this person sees you as somebody who's very wise, very knowing, very knowledgeable, somebody who's very strong, stable, sturdy, solid, somebody who cares very much about family. I feel like this person sees you as somebody who cherishes your family. Your family is your friends. This person may say a lot of things about how you might be able to talk to spirits on the other side. You might get a lot of messages from the angels, from the divine, from your ancestors. I feel like a lot of you, it's from your ancestors. I feel like a lot of you may have more like druidism or shamanic beliefs, more similar to that, maybe even Wiccan or voodoo. But this person really has a lot to say about how skilled you are, how knowledgeable you are, how wise you are. We have the Exalted Urchin, the Lord Regent, and you know what? This person may know all of those things about you, and they may say things that are very, very different from that. They may say that you are just a child and you're exalted for nothing, and that you don't deserve the attention that you get. You don't deserve the praise that you get. This person may be somebody who's very cocky. They may be somebody who's very harsh, judgmental, overly critical, analytical. This could be somebody that is very, has a very commanding presence. They may lead in a very authoritarian way, and they may even project that onto you. They may view you as leading in a very authoritarian way. They may also view you as, you know, you could work with a lot of children that other people have thrown in the trash, or people that have other people have thrown in the trash and just see as trash. And you may actually take on the dirty work and the role of helping these people climb their way up out of that. And this person may see that as well. So we got the Knight of Cups and we got the Moon. This person sees you as somebody who's dreamy, romantic, poetic, maybe even a little emotionally immature, or they may be very emotionally immature. They may feel like they're very childish emotionally and that you have helped them see things from a higher perspective, but this is hidden. They don't reveal this. They don't allow other people to see this. There could be some moon magic here too. If you had an intimate relationship with this person and you guys ever had sex outside under the moon, there could be some moon magic here. You could be a Cancer. There's a lot hidden here beneath the surface. I feel like a lot of the way that this person rules has been hidden from you. And I feel like you know anyway. You're very intuitive. You're very emotional. You're very sensitive. You may even be psychic. You're somebody who really sees who this person truly is. Even if they've tried to distort the view, even if they've tried to keep you from seeing who they really are, you know who they really are. And this person knows who you really are. And they may distort the view a bit when they're telling who you are because they don't want anybody to know the truth that they were the one who messed up this situation. Because I feel like this is a very messed up situation from the past. And this person screwed things up and they don't want anybody to know that. But at the same time, they really, I feel like they may even want to come forward and express some sort of emotion to you, some sort of apology to you or love to you. And they may be still in an emotionally immature state. Everyone is so proud of you. You are glowing and looking good too. You have been working so hard. Your dedication and commitment is amazing. You are truly one of a kind, and your work ethic is on point. And like I was saying, you could work with children, especially children that have been, you know that program, No Child Left Behind? It's like you are that program. You go and find the invisible ones. You go and find the ones people have thrown in the trash and given up on. You go and find the ones that nobody wants to work with, and you work with those people. And this person's very proud of you for that. Everyone is very proud of you for that. Everyone sees you as this amazing person, which is also partially why this person keeps their opinions to themselves regarding you, because they see it too. When they do say something about you, they may say something harsh, they may say something nice, but it's kind of an equal thing. They don't want anybody to think they think so highly of you because they may have lost you in the past. You are so powerful. Your presence is seen and felt. Your strength and power is a force to be reckoned with. So you are a force to be reckoned with. You are a leader. You are strong. You are dominant. You are in charge. And people can feel you when you walk into a room. And I don't feel like you are somebody who is harsh and overbearing and hurtful and overly critical or authoritarian, but you are somebody who commands respect because you are respect. You have fought long and hard. Be proud of all you have achieved so far. Celebrate your wins and take some time out for play and fun. Why so serious? All work and no play is making you a little crazy. Time to fix that by bringing it back more into balance. And I feel like you may have actually helped this person bring out their childlike side. They may have buried that childlike side because they may have thought that that was a bad thing. It was a bad thing to not be serious all the time, to be irresponsible in any way whatsoever. And so they could have even taken some of that out on you by thinking that you were irresponsible at one point in time, but they're realizing now that you weren't. And I feel like they feel the same way about you. Like, you guys were mirroring each other very strongly, and both of you guys are workaholics. And you guys put far too much time and effort into work and don't take so much time out for play and fun and happiness and joy. And you need to start doing that. Multifaceted, creative, quirky, and good at multitasking. Can make something from nothing, very out there, a bit over the top, but very grounded. Can do so many different things and is very good at them. So this person sees you as very good at anything artistic, anything creative, anything that has anything to do with building or constructing anything. And they really see you as somebody who's a bit over the top, but you're very, very grounded, very stable, very strong. And that's what they're telling people. You walked out on your family. You don't care about anyone but yourself. You are a narcissist. Others envy your self-love and self-respect, and they don't have any themselves, so they see it as selfishness. No worries. They are just the toxic side of a martyr. So I feel like this person is saying, because I feel like this person may actually be defending you against people who are saying you walked out on your family. Or again, family friend. They could be somebody who's a friend of your family, and they may have insinuated themselves in there. And so they could be talking trash, saying that you walked out on your family. I don't think you have. I think, once again, it's about self-love and self-respect and boundaries. And you have loved yourself, respected yourself, and set boundaries, and other people can't handle it, so you can't be around them. And if they can handle it, you can keep them around. And this person may have a hard time doing that, so they may see you as selfish or toxic or narcissistic, and this person just is that themselves, in a way. This person may actually defend your name as well, though. I'm kind of feeling for a lot of you, a lot of you. This person is defending your name and saying that people are just martyrs and toxic and are busy doing things to please everyone around them, so they can't handle the fact that you're done pleasing everyone around you. A fraud that uses charisma or manipulation to get others to do your bidding. You are someone that is cruel and uncaring. You get what you want and you leave, trying to shine a light on you to avoid others seeing them. So this person may be very charismatic, may be very manipulative, very cruel, uncaring, cold, selfish. They may be a workaholic, and they may not have given you the time or priority you deserved in their life, and you may have walked away from them for that. And so this person tells everyone else that you walked away from them because you got what you wanted, and then you left. And you know what? That's their own business. They'll get theirs. So anyway, why did they do this? I can't say no or set healthy boundaries. The toxic side of a martyr. Can't say no, can't set healthy boundaries as a people pleaser. And so they're running around telling everybody nasty things about you because they can't make those changes in their own life to where they are living the life they want to live. They felt that they would gain popularity through turning against you. Your optimism, hope, and happiness makes them salty. And advice from spirit. Focus on peaceful and harmonious ways of doing things. Stay on your path and working towards your goals. So try to really be peaceful and harmonious.